Today we're gonna do an overhaul on the master cylinder, see if we can get these lines off, get the master cylinder rebuild kit in, and make this thing look a little better than what it does now. What I did so far, just real quick, is make sure I got all the parts and bits and pieces that I need. Crush washers, and brake fluid, and just lots of rags and stuff like that. There's a lot of things that are in the manual that are, it's all good information, but of course they miss a few things like loosening the nut, securing the right hand mirror. My note, it's left hand threads, of course. Almost every Virago you'll see, if somebody doesn't know what they're doing or if they haven't worked on these things before, you'll see the right hand mirror chewed up. You know, grab the manual, print the pages off that are applicable to, this is my diagram here. So I've got the rebuild kit. I've got pretty much everything else I need. I'm going to clean up these wires in the ultrasonic cleaner. Like I said, we'll review this. We'll take all the fluid out, take the system apart, clean it all up, overhaul the master cylinder, and get that sight glass in. Hopefully I bought a sight glass, and hopefully it's the right one and it's going to fit properly, because once I take it apart I'm kind of committed. And there's really not a lot of information. There's nothing in the climber manual anyway. I've got both and I had a look. There's nothing that talks about getting that replacement window out, but I'll get the part and I'll show you what it looks like. What I bought was a master cylinder rebuild kit and K&L. Pretty happy with the K&L carb kit, so a little more expensive, but he's made in Japan and everything seems to be fitting really, really well. I bought this little thing off Amazon, which is a one-way check valve. I'm not going to use this when I drain the brakes, but when I bleed them, this is cool. So basically what this is you attach this to your little bleed screw, and as the fluid comes out, it'll only go out in one direction. It won't back up, so you're not going to draw air back into the system. That's kind of cool. Never actually used one before. I've always done it the hard way. I've also went and bought these little caps, these rubber caps. I checked mine are okay, but I'm going to replace them anyway. And I'll keep these on hand. I'm just going to do it. I'm going to do all the cosmetic stuff when I do the restoration. The actual plan is to tear this right down to the frame and rebuild everything. So there is a couple of these. I should have bought a couple more because I know I'm probably going to end up breaking one. But these are the little sight glass. They call them sight glass, but I'm pretty sure they're like a polycarbonate or something like that. They're not. No, I don't think they're glass at all. But anyway, they come with an O-ring. Got a couple of them here, which is great. I'm just going to mic these out with the micrometer and make sure that they're the right size and go for that. So that's pretty much all the parts I need. I've got DOT-3 brake fluid. This pretty much should be all I need to do this. It specs out 3 or 4. I think it came with 3 originally. So that's my DOT-3 brake fluid. Safety glasses and lots of rags, and I also bought a bunch of these little syringes for doing little odd jobs. I might actually, when I get towards the end of it, I might actually just draw this out of the thing and do my master cylinder, fill that up. So that's pretty much everything you need to do this. Of course, it's not just the overhaul kit. I need to get these rusty wires. Hopefully soaking in some kind of a vinegar or something like that might take all that off. But like I said, I've got to pull this off to get at the union and then get all the bits and pieces down. And of course, before I do all that, take it apart, I've got to bleed the brakes. The switch has to come off as well. That's in the procedure. And I'll make sure that I get as much on the video as possible. But anyway, this is what the plan is, and we'll see how this goes today. first things first is this mirror's got to come off. And like I mentioned before, you'll see these are all chewed up. It's a 17 mil. Don't use SAE, but 17 mil. And just try to tighten it. It's backwards threads. And it'll come right out. Comes out nice and easy on mine. Again, backwards threads on this. But what's weird is it's regular threads on the top. So if you ever order mirrors for the Virago, and I probably end up, I will, I'll have to get, you definitely got to make sure you get it right and the left because there is a difference. All right, after you get the mirror off, you'll have to take this little rubber thing away and get at the switch here. Now, somebody's put a tie wrap here, so I'm just going to cut that off. I don't think that's stock. And then what you're going to end up seeing is that there's a clip that holds this whole thing in. So I'm just going to pull the rubber. I'll take the rubber off and set that aside. Okay, after you get the mirror off and you get this rubber boot removed, there's a switch right here. And the way this comes off, you can use a little screwdriver like this, but be kind of gentle. There's a hole in the bottom. It's kind of hard to see where the camera is, but all you do is just push up on that. Just push very gently into the hole and you'll feel a little bit of resistance, springy resistance. And that's just a little spring-loaded clip that snaps down into the hole and out comes the whole switch. That's a little bit of pressure that you're pushing up with the screwdriver. So just be real gentle with that. This one's in really good shape, so you don't have to take anything else off. You don't have to take the clip off or anything like that. And this can just sort of sit here. You can push it away out of the way as we're going to get at the rest of this here in a second. We're going to drain the brakes now, get the all the fluid out, and then we'll take the master cylinder. We'll disconnect this banjo bolt right here. And like I said, you'll need new crush washers with every joint. Hopefully I'll be able to just slide these off and over this little joint right here where the banjo bolt goes through. So here's what I'm up against. I've got the main line that comes down to the union here, to the split. And then these have been covered up, I don't know for how many years. Cosmetics is one thing. I wanted to be more concerned about that when I do the restoration. But for now, it is an eyesore. It's been bugging me for a while. And of course, I wanted to get that master cylinder looked at too. So what we'll do is we're going to come down here. We're going to connect our hose, our drain hose, to the little nipple right here. And I'm just going to drain it into a bottle. And mark it, of course, so I know what it is. And then, of course, I'll have access to these springs here on the bottom part. So there's a couple of unions here, just a clip right there that I'll have to take that out. And so first things first is we'll drain the fluid out of the brake lines on both sides. Right, so like a lot of old bikes, it's always a surprise when you try to get things apart. But in this case, this bike has been pretty good. There's been a few times I've come across a few things where, you know, screws have been tightened down too much. Okay, so this cap has got a little bit of corrosion around the top. Once I pull this apart, in order to get a good seal again, I'm going to have to just get this corrosion removed, and however I do that, I'll just decide that at the time. But so now I'm going to go down to the bottom, connect my bottle, and get the brake lines cleared out. Just remove the little rubber cap, and the line will go on here. This is going to be an 8 millimeter, and all you do is just drain the brake fluid, just let gravity make its way through. So I'm going to put the box end on this to get it loosened. Just get a little more grip. All right, so that's all I needed there. Put the bottle back on and loosen this up and let it drain. Like I said, the last thing you want to do is strip this. So I'll let that go. I'm going to squeeze the handle a few times and get that out and just let that fill up, and then I'll get the other side. And then once all the fluid's out, then we'll take the next step. So I'm just squeezing the brake lever just to get the rest of that fluid out of the lines. There's still going to be a little bit of residual brake fluid, which is why you really want to be careful once you take these lines off, because there's going to be a little bit of drip in there. So just be careful when you do this. Again, there's not a lot of fluid, only probably about a cup of fluid in the entire system. Okay, once we got most of the, or as much of the fluid drained out of the left and the right side as possible, next thing that we're going to do is remove the banjo bolts at the fittings. And then we'll be able to take the whole assembly off the handlebars. So I just put a cap over this. I noticed that as I was squeezing the levers, tiny little droplets everywhere. So I've just covered up my workspace just to make sure that I, you know, eliminate or reduce as much as I can and any chance of getting brake fluid anywhere. So these are 12 millimeters. And again, there's a little union down here. I took this cross cover off. That's just a cosmetic piece. And these will be coming off as well. I'll probably take this out just to clean it. And yeah, and then the two lines that go down as well, I'll take those off as well. So these are all 12 millimeter. And a good idea to keep track of all your parts, which side is which, just in case. So when you lay it down somewhere, you know exactly how it all goes together. So that's the next step, and we'll get that out on the bench. So when you undo this bolt, just check for dirt. Have a look around and see. You'll notice that there's a couple of crush washers, one on each side. Recover those. You won't be using them again, of course. And again, aluminum or copper in this case is fine. I'm sure you get into a huge social media debate over this, but it's so long as you've got something that's softer than the metal that you're connecting to. So these are fairly hard steel. All you're looking to do is just make sure you got a clean mating surface and you have either a copper or an aluminum crush washer. And like I said, there's 9 of them in this whole assembly. So make sure you have those on hand, or else you'll be sitting around waiting. And sometimes if you live in a place where, you know, parts aren't available, then, you know, that's why it's always nice to have everything ready for you before you go. So, all right. So next bit is to take these lines off down near the bottom of the brake calipers. Okay, so there's just behind the reflector, there's little rubber clips, and then that'll be pretty much the entire system right from top to bottom you'll be able to remove. So the next one to come out will be these bolts in the bottom, one on each side. Again, just make sure you be cautious of any leaking brake fluid that comes out of these lines. Okay, I got it out. Not much trouble at all. Pretty quick job, actually. Just want to make sure, like I said, that you kind of document everything, take pictures. If this is your first time doing this, just like I said, take your time and ask questions. You know, if you have a friend next door, or you know somebody who's a mechanic or whatever, ask lots of questions. There's some pretty good forums out there, but be choosy what you see on the internet, including this one, of course. And just take your time, follow the service manual, and it should be pretty straightforward. The biggest thing when you're working on these bikes, when you're working on the brake system, of course, is spilling brake fluid everywhere. So that's the lines off. We're going to come back to this here in a minute, the master cylinder. I've got some work to do on that, but I just wanted to show you where I'm at right now. This is the little boot that covers the top end. These are these really nasty lines that I was hoping to get. Hopefully I can get these off and get them repaired or cleaned or whatever. Replace at the worst end of it. But yeah, so there's the union, the joint. We've got a definite right and a definite left. And I'll mark those. That way they go back to where they're supposed to be. And I don't know if that was a pressed on or not. No, but anyway, there's just a little, that's the rubber grommet that it fits into the bracket just on each side of the wheel. So my task today is to get these lines off and get these cleaned up right here. So we'll see if I can do that. Okay, just had a look at these wires, and I'm not going to be able to get that braided line off the end. It's just the fittings are just too large, either the top or the bottom end. So the whole purpose is to get this clean, of course. And the two chemicals that I was planning on using, either CLR or vinegar, neither one of them is safe for rubber, and it wouldn't be wise to put these in like a chemical solution with the brake hoses. So I'm gonna put that on hold for now, and I may end up just ordering new lines, new stainless steel lines. We'll see how that goes. And if that's what I have to do, that's what I have to do. And if I can't clean these up, I probably won't put them on back on like that. I'll probably just replace them. Moving on to removing the master cylinder from the handlebar. Pretty straightforward, just a 10 millimeter. So it comes off. There's an up and a down to this, so you can't mess this up. And of course, this is pretty obvious which way it goes. So let's get this on the bench. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do is soak up as much of that residual brake fluid as I can. And while I'm doing that, I'll take this off. Looks like another 10 mil, which it is. That should come off pretty easily. This is the part that we'll be replacing here. So this rubber seal's got to come out, just a weather seal. All right, so hopefully that's a slightly better view. This looks like it's probably gonna end up going in the ultrasonic bath. There's a lot of corrosion. I don't know if you can see it or not. I got the light kind of hard to see, but anyway, there's a lot of corrosion here. Hopefully my pliers will be able to get this clip out, because this can be a royal pain in the butt. All right, so that wasn't too painful. Circlip, of course, is in pretty good shape. So these are all just a little bit different. And of course, I'm just gonna show you the inside here. I don't know if you can tell or not, but there's quite a bit of corrosion on the outside. But it looks like this is just some dirt, just some buildup on the inside. And what I'm gonna do is, just because of the fact that I want to get rid of this and replace this, I'm gonna fire up the ultrasonic cleaner. Even though it's just for one part, I'm gonna do that. So we'll give that a go. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have to pop this glass out, and this can be a bit of a challenge too. But before I do that, I'm gonna measure my new one and make sure it is in fact the right one. Okay, I'm sure these are metric, but all I want to do is just get a measurement. And that checks out. So that'll be my replacement glass right there. There is a little bit of a nib on that plastic. I'm sure that's just a mold mark. I'll have to shave that off with a knife, but what's gonna happen here is this one's gonna come out hopefully in one piece. If not, I'll have to dig it out. So this one comes out, O-ring goes in, all the surfaces have to be cleaned, and then the O-ring goes in. And then you press this one in, either with a C clamp or a vise or some kind of a woodworking clamp or something. Okay, so here's the plan. I don't want to bang it out or drill it out or anything, so I found a washer that fits right inside the glass. And then I have this nut insert. I'm going to put that in there like that. I'm going to put a large socket on the other side of the glass, and hopefully I can get a C clamp in there to basically just act as like a press, like a bearing press, and get that out. All right, looks like I need about 17 sets of hands here, and no help in sight. But here's the go, and out she came pretty quick. So there's the old sight glass, as you can see. There's a little bit of residue in there, and I think the old ring is in there still too, so I can still see the ring holding the. So that's got to come out. So that's just the glass. So what's stuck in here is that the outside ring, like a bearing race. And that's got to come out. So I've got to very carefully fish that out, and maybe I might be able to get it out with a screwdriver. I can feel the softness of the rubber O-ring in there. But I may need to... Oh, wow, that O-ring is completely... Might be able to get at it and push through it on this side. Anyway, I'm going to turn this off for a second. I'm going to mess around with this. So I got the ring out, and that was actually easier than I thought it was. I just... Because the ring comes up over the outer casting, I was able to pop it up that way without doing any damage. Now, again, there's probably... Yep, there's the other O-ring. And that's all going to get cleaned up. So that's a bit of a mess. I wasn't expecting to have to throw this in the ultrasonic cleaner, because I have a big one and this is a small part. So that's exactly what's going to happen. I'll throw all that in here, and I'll just use a mild degreaser and a little bit of detergent. And of course, this is going to have to be blown out completely with the air compressor once it's been cleaned, because you don't want any contaminant fluids in here at all. So a little more work than I expected, but that's fine. And again, the new part is going to be the new O-ring is going to go in here, and then the new sight glass, and that should look really nice when it's all back together. Probably a good time anyway to refresh these parts as well. So that's what I'm going to do. I don't think there's anything else that needs to go in the cleaner at this time. So I'll stop it here. And of course, these parts are garbage, of course, for sure. They can't be reused ever at all. But as you can see, there's quite a bit of sun fading and crazing. It's looking better every day. A little bit of extra work for me, but I don't mind at all. I really enjoy this. All right, quickly becoming my favorite new gadget is my ultrasonic cleaner. It's nice because we can use, non-caustic chemicals in here, very, very gentle chemicals like Simple Green and Spray 9 and just, household soaps. Some have detergent, some don't. Just pick the one you want, mix it down with water. And of course, it's got a heater on it. The heater takes forever to heat up. But anyway, I got this. The kit comes with the big basket, which has some, you can see the holes in it, some pretty large holes in it. A lot of the small stuff when I was cleaning the carburetors, the jets and stuff would obviously fall through. So they include this little tea bag apparatus, which is nice for the really, really tiny stuff. This is actually kind of cool because it's going to be small enough that I can put in, the screen is small enough, I can just drop that little spring in there. So all of these parts, I'll be able to put them in here, and I'll take this apart, of course, and I'll put the brake cylinder in there too. And anything else, I think I'll look around the shop and see what I got that I think I can clean up. These hoses, I don't think I'm gonna risk putting them in there, even though I probably could, but I'm not gonna risk it right now. But that looks pretty cool. It's already starting to warm up. It's going to be a while, so obviously I'll cut that. All these parts are ready to go in. I'm going to disassemble this right down as far as I can get it in. Very generic. So this is all going to come apart, go in my new little basket, which is kind of cool. Anything else I can find that I need to clean up around the shop right now will go in here. And then the master cylinder, going to go in my cleaner and take it from there.